I love catchy songs that have substance. The ultimate goal for me is to have something, you know, that somebody can sing along to, but that also has, you know, some meat on its bones, I guess.
If you ain't got two kids by 21, you're probably gonna die alone. At least that's what tradition told you.
I grew up in a really tiny little town in East Texas. First years of my life, I lived in a yellow trailer. Huge stickers out in the yard. I could never go barefoot out there. That's pretty much all I remember, that, and that there were other people's cows always in our yard. I feel so lucky because I've had an entire family that has supported me from day one. My grandparents and my parents would like load me up in the van, and we would travel to every little Opry in Texas and festival and pretty much anything that I could sing at. And I grew up singing like Western swing music, and looking back, you know, I mean, I definitely appreciate growing up with music like that, but whenever you're a kid in a high school or middle school and you're singing Western swing and you're wearing a 10-gallon hat and fringe, it's just your target. My grandpa had this amazing record collection. He still has it. So that was really cool and an easy way to have access to music that I would have never heard of otherwise. I got my first guitar when I was 12. I started taking lessons from this guy in town. He would give me my homework for the week. He would tell me to go write a song. And even if it was bad, just get it out. It just sparked my love for writing, and it taught me to put it on paper even if it was terrible. It was just a cool early introduction to all of that, and that's why I love songwriting so much.
Just like dust, we settle in this town. On this broken my bangs with some rusty kitchen scissors. I screamed his name till the neighbors called the cops.
Well, I hope when people hear my music, they feel like it's different. It's blunt, it's hopefully to the point, and hopefully people would say that it's real.
It's your makeup, girl, it's just a breakup running. Hide your crazy and start acting like a lady.
I'm influenced by a huge range of music, and I really hope that when people hear my music, they will get that.
Casey's young, but she knows music, country music specifically, long before her time. Those artists are all people that come from a place that is very, looks very real on them. Mm-hmm. And so I think it was a matter of finding what looked real on you.
Yeah, and just what felt real.
Yeah.
To be holding the matches when the fire trucks show up and there's nobody else to blame.
I started making my record in December of last year, and it was a 6-month recording process, and it was absolutely amazing. I felt like I got to do whatever I wanted to do, and it was so freeing. They let me pick the songs that I wanted to pick, and they let me pick my producers. I picked two friends and co-writers that I've been writing with since I moved to town, Luke Laird and Shane McNally. I feel like we're all three influenced by like exactly the same things as far as, you know, like old school country, like Glen Campbell, Marty Robbins, stuff like that, but also like, you know, 90s hip hop or whatever it is. And it's like, there's something in that.
Really, anything that makes us feel
sick. Yeah, it's just, we're just like, yeah, we just love the same kind of music no matter the genre. The goal for this record was just to say something different. I mean, but we didn't really, I feel like, have to try that hard because our songs were already from a different perspective.
When you say a line to Casey, when she sings it back to you, you no longer even know if the line is good because she sings so good.
Oh.
She has such perfect timing. She sounds the way I imagine an angel would sing. I mean, which is ironic considering the way you act, but...